What's going on, fantasy entertainer, the motivator, the educator, Lucky Murray, back with another Gamecock News update. And today I'm doing a quick video. Players who made the preseason All-SEC honors. So it's an article on 247sports.com, my favorite blog site, that said players who could earn preseason All-SEC honors. Before I go any further, man, do one of three things. One, like the video. Helps out with the algorithms on YouTube. Please like the video. It's free. Stop right there. Like it if you watch the video. Two, subscribe to the channel, because most of you guys are not subscribed. There's a lot of my subscribers who watch my videos, but some of you guys are not subscribed. Subscribe to the channel. Also, three, hit the notification bell. Notification bell, you know, every time I drop a video, and a separate one, share the video as well. So let's read the article for 247sports.com. It says players who could earn postseason All-SEC honors. And I'm going to give you my opinion. Man! So it says there were three South Carolina football players who earned preseason All-SEC honors from the SEC media, but none really came as a surprise. All three players who were named to either the first or second team by Athlon magazine or Phil Steele. Edge rusher Kingsley Mbare was picked first team, while running back Kevin Harris earned a second team nod. Tight end Nick Muse grabbed third team honors from the league's voting members of the media. If the South Carolina football team is going to exceed expectations, the over-under win total is set to be out of 3.5 or 4 wins, depending on the sports book. There will likely be a couple of other players who will find their ways onto postseason or SEC teams, but it's from the league's coaches and one of the other publications. So let's keep this going, man, because real quick, a lot of people put too much stock on the preseason all SEC teams. And coaches, they vote on players based off what they believe. So a lot of players may or may not get their proper respect. Kevin Harris, who led the league last year as far as rushing, gets second team all SEC. I think that's a understatement. I think that he'll be first team. But they're looking at people from Alabama, looking at from Georgia back. They're looking at it was a down year, and they said, yeah, you know, he had a good year, but could he duplicate that? And also, I think that there are going to be more Gamecocks that go in that list as well. I think that we're going to have some defensive players to step up. I think that we may have two running backs that go on the list. I think we'll have a wide receiver to carry on Jonah. I think EJ Jenkins may land on that list, because Nick Muse already said in his SEC media days, he said that, you know, we could be A and B. You know, he could play receiver and tight end. So I'm looking at a lot of other people. You know, Luke Doty, if he has a pretty good year, he could make, you know, all, you know, mentions of the SEC team. He may make third or second team. So there's a lot of ifs, ands, buts, what ifs. But my main thing is that, look here, I love it when we are not projected to do great, because that's when projections are low and things are going to be high. So here's what I need y'all to do. Let me know what y'all think about this in the comment section below. Again, it's the entertainer, motivator, educator, Lucky Murray, back with another Gamecock News update. And yes, they're sleeping on us really hard. As you can see, we only have three players made the preseason All-SEC team. But it doesn't matter, because in September, we're going to show them why, you know, they're sleeping on the Gamecocks. Let me know what you think about it in the comment section below. But like always, it's the next time, people.